had a choice. And that's that one of my online pastor friends told this story. And he said that he had gathered with a new group of pastors who didn't know each other very well. And the person who was leading the meeting decided that they would share stories with each other about what they had done over the summer. Okay? And the person who had experienced the coolest summer would get a candy bar for a reward. This is a group of pastors. Stephen says, sounds awesome. Hi, Theo, come on up. Okay, so what would you be thinking if somebody set up that kind of game? You said it's awesome. Anybody else? Sounds like a big contest. Okay, and you'd be racking your brain, right, trying to think of the best story you could think of, right, out of everything that happened over the summer. Okay. Well, this pastor who was telling the story was pretty wise. And he said, well, I'm sure going to lose this competition because I spent part of the summer in Nebraska and it was over 100 degrees. Okay? And the other pastors understood. They decided that if the coolest summer meant the lowest temperature, then they could easily decide who had the coolest summer, right? And it turned out one of them went to Alaska, so obviously she won. Okay. So, but if you tried to decide between, say, you spent the summer going to visit Grandma and Grandpa in Sacramento, and somebody else spent the summer going to Nebraska to see wild, Africa, that's the word, to see wild elephants. Anyway, but the difference between going to Sacramento to see your grandparents and going to Africa to see wild elephants, what would be the coolest? Elephants. Yeah. Well, they went out every time, wouldn't they? Okay. All right. So another of my pastor friends, in talking about a new church service that a lot of people go to, said this week, there's nothing wrong with being big. And I have to agree, there's nothing wrong with being big. But I have to be honest with myself that it would be great to have this place packed full of people on Sunday mornings and have our beautiful acoustics ringing with all of our voices and stuff, right? Well, the problem for me is not that this pastor's service has a lot of people coming. It's that I feel a little envy, a little jealousy that keeps me hooked into that competition. And I don't want to be there. Okay. So Jesus helps us to think about stuff like this today. His friends have been walking with him, but they've been walking a little apart from him. And they've been arguing. And when he asked them what they were arguing about, they're quiet. Because they've been caught. They know that they shouldn't have been arguing, but they were arguing about who was the greatest. Okay. So greatest. Think about that word for a minute. What are the last three letters of the word greatest?
E-S-T.
E-S-T. Okay. All right. So, can you think of other words that end in E-S-T?
Smallest.
Smallest. Okay. What other words end in E-S-T?
Largest.
Largest. Somebody raise a hand over here? No? Okay.
Smartest.
Smartest. Okay. What other?
Nicest.
Nicest. Shortest? Okay. All right.
Tallest.
Tallest?
Richest.
Biggest? Yep. Okay. All of those words end in E-S-T. Okay. So in a lot of those words that end in E-S-T, you could also have an end in E-R, right? Smarter, bigger, those kind of things. Okay. So if someone is the greatest, that person would be the closest to being perfect, right? Was it Muhammad Ali who said that? I'm the greatest? Okay. Well, I don't know. Everybody over time? Who knows? Anyway. But Jesus then, he does something that surprises his friends. He sits down. Well, first he says to them, whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all. And then he sits down and he takes the child, and in the middle of the circle of the disciples, he says, whoever welcomes a child like this in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes not me, but the one who sent me. Okay? So who sent Jesus to live in the world?
God.
That's great. Yes, it was God. Okay, so what we don't really think about is the fact that that children really weren't seen in Jesus' time. They just weren't seen very much. It wasn't really until early adulthood that they started to pay attention to littler people. Okay? So when Jesus and the child sit in the middle of the circle, he's saying, look at this child. He's saying, welcoming all people is the way to welcome God. And these days, we'd also say, and welcoming God and those people, we recognize how those relationships are surprising gifts to us as well. Okay. And we could also add that these things don't make us any better than anyone else. And I'll list a few things. Being nicest to other people. We like to be nice to other people, but it doesn't make us any better than anybody else, right? Coming to church the most often. That's nice, but it doesn't make us any better than anybody else. Putting the most money in the offering plate. That's nice also, but it doesn't make us any better than anybody else. Having the largest church gatherings, praying the most often, or helping poor people the most. We do those things because Jesus wants us to. He wants us to serve others. But he also wants us to get off the comparison merry-go-round. And I call it a merry-go-round because it can take us for quite a ride. Okay? Let's imagine that just being good is good enough. Okay? We don't have to be better or best. Being smart is good enough. We don't have to be smarter or smartest in comparison to someone else. Everyone is good and smart and great in their own way, because God created us that way. Another one of my friends said this week, and I really admire this person. I love this. It's often said that the perfect is the enemy of the good. When God created the world, he didn't call it perfect. He called it good. Okay? So we don't have to go around trying to be perfect, trying to be the best there is. We all have good gifts and enough time, and we trust that God shows us how to do good things in the world. And that's all we need to know.